Welcome to Mass for the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time from Queen of Angels Church at Queen of Angels and St. Matthias Parish in Chicago. Our pastor, Monsignor Jim Kaczorowski, is the celebrant. There is a link to the worship video for this Mass on the Mass stream page of the parish website. The worship aid includes some music for the Mass, a link to the readings, and the prayer for spiritual communion, which we will pray together at communion.
For it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy the author of all that is good, through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is beyond, is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing promise. She brings him good and not evil all the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the distaff and her fingers ply the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her reward for her labors, and let her works praise her at the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Concerning times and seasons, brothers and sisters, you have no need for anything to be written to you. For you yourselves know very well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief at night. When people are saying peace and security, then sudden disaster comes upon them, like labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they will not escape. But you, brothers and sisters, are not in darkness, for that day will overtake you like a thief. For all of you are children of the light and children of the day. We are not in the night or darkness. Therefore, Let us not sleep as the rest do. Let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possessions to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to a third 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the man who received 1 went off, dug a hole in the ground, and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward, bringing the additional 5. He said, "Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you greater responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who had received 2 talents also came forward and said, "Master, you gave me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who had received the 1 talent came forward and said, "Master, I know you were a demanding person, harvesting where you did not plant, gathering where you did not scatter. So out of fear, I went off and buried your talent in the ground. Here it is back." His master said to him in reply, "You wicked, lazy mouth. So you knew that I harvest where I did not plant and gather where I did not scatter. Should you not then have put my money in the bank so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given and he will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into darkness outside, where there will be a wailing and grinding of teeth." The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My friends, as I shared with you last week, last week's gospel, this week's gospel, and the gospel next week are the eschatological readings. And our Lord is helping us to prepare for our death and for afterlife. We had the five foolish and the five wise virgins last week. Today we have the parable of the talents. We have a parable of a wealthy man who wants to take a long trip, and he really trusts and has confidence in these three servants. And he gives a great amount of his possessions to them, maybe all of them, is not said. He gives five talents to one servant, two talents to the other, and one to another. A talent today, in today's money, would be worth about $5 million. So he was giving like $25 million to the first servant, $20 million to the second, $10 million to the second, and $5 million to the third. Mathematically, that comes out to about $40 million. And he goes on a trip. And after a long period of time, comes back and wants an account of his life, of his possessions, his money. So the first servant comes to him and tells him, I invested your $25 million. We made $25 million more, $50 million. And the master said, you're a faithful and a good servant. Come and share in your master's joy. And then the second one said, well, with the $10 million you gave me, I made 10 more, I doubled it. He said, you're a very faithful and good servant. Come and share in your master's joy. And then the one that he gave the one talent, the $5 million, he said he was afraid to invest it. He was afraid to lose money. So he hoarded it. He buried it in the ground. And then he gives it back to him. And the master says to him, you lazy servant, you lazy lout. Couldn't you just put it in the bank and made interest on it? He tells his other servants, well, just take this servant out. Throw him out in the darkness. Well, there'll be wailing and grinding of teeth. Well, he will never enjoy the master presence, the master's joy, sharing it. My friends, the wealthy man is God. The servants are you and me. And sharing in the master's joy is heaven. And our Lord has given us all gifts, some more than others. Why? I don't know. Let the Lord explain that to you one day. But we all have gifts to share with one another. And to get to the chase, either we use these gifts or we lose them. We can't keep them for ourselves. So let's just go through three gifts or resources the Lord has given all of us. Just talk about them a little bit. The first one is time. We're all given that gift of time. Now, some of us save time for ourselves that we never have time to make that phone call to our sick parent or a parent that is far away, never have time to help our children with our homework, never have time to listen to our wife what happened during the day, never have time to go shopping with them. And there are other people that have plenty of time for their family, and when the interruptions come into their life, there are their life, as we spoke about, their interruptions are our life. They have time to write a card to someone who is sick. They have a time to call someone and thank them for something they did. They hear from a friend, this person is doing well, and they give them a call or have time to send them an email. People who need to live out their gifts. And what happens when these people live out their gifts, the kingdom grows. The kingdom grows because they touch another person's life, another person feels that joy, and then the person touches other people's lives, and Christ grows the kingdom through those loyal servants, loyal disciples of Christ. Let's take another resource we all have, a little amount of money. There are some people who save their money and hoard it and can't let go of it. They're like bald people collecting combs, never use it for anything. These are people who are saying that they're saving their money for a rainy day. A rainy day that never comes and they die. Now, there are other people that reasonably and sensibly spend their money on their families and pay their bills and make sure children have clothes and everything is fine at home, but always have enough of money for other people's needs. These are the people who always donate to the food drives. These are the people who donate to the church regularly. These are the people who, when you have a fundraiser, they're here to help you in any little or big way. They share. And the whole movement, all these things I'm sharing with you now, time and now money, is the movement from self to other, from selfishness to communion, and from isolation to community, which are all called that by Christ to be one. Christ died that we all may be one. The third one is work. There are some people who save their work as if something spectacular is going to happen in some unknown future. These are the people who have very little energy when they work. These are the people that are robotic. These are the people that teach you, but they know you're just there because they have to be, not because they want to be. These are the people who would do a job, but not with enthusiasm. One of my priest friends, when we were in college, in graduate school, we worked on the docks. And there was some of these guys would load the truck, would take them 8 hours to load a truck, it would take an hour. It was like watching paint dry. And there were other people with enthusiasm that loaded their truck and got to the next truck and whatever. There are people that do things with enthusiasm. There are people, the people at the checkout counter, the woman who smiles at you and asks you, how are things going? Or there's the pharmacist who really cares about the medication they give you. There's a doctor who's really invested in you, not only your physical problems, but your emotional things. Hey, Father Jim, my doctor says, how are things going with you? Because you're working later years than you should be. How are things going? How are things going emotionally during the COVID-19 period? So you have people that work enthusiastically for you. These are people who would rather wear out their resources rather than let them rust out. So my dear friends, our Lord is helping us to prepare for death. How are we going to use our resources? Three simple ones I shared with you today are time, money, and work, and there are many more. Maybe a good exercise you can do is think about all the ancestors that you've had, living and deceased, mostly the deceased one, who really affected and touched your life, and really paid it forward in moving from self to other. Really use their resources of hospitality or kindness or generosity that moves you to do that. And then thank God for all those people that have helped you and each other to help Christ build the kingdom through each and every one of us. Pray that, to the dear Lord that we use our gifts for others and not keep them for ourselves. Because the alternative, the consequences are bleak. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us now pray for the needs of our brothers and sisters, especially the most vulnerable, and for our own personal intentions.
Please, respond to each intercession, Lord, hear our prayer. For all the church, may we appreciate all that God has entrusted to us, and may we be good stewards of those gifts, to each according to their ability. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For both Francis, Brenna Sukic, Monsignor Jim, Father Larry, and all the clergy, may they each continue to reach out their hands to the poor and extend their arms to the needy. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parents, may they encourage their children's gifts, so that those gifts will be used for the good of others. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all spouses, may they recognize their value to each other, a value far beyond pearls, and may they grow in their love for each other. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our political leaders, may they consider the needs of the poor and the plight of citizens whose lives have been turned inside out by the pandemic as they use the resources of our country. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our confirmation candidates on their first virtual retreat this weekend, may they feel the presence of the Holy Spirit among them as they bring all that they are to each challenge they undertake. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of the Queen of Angels in St. Matthias Parish, may we become shining examples of Christ in our neighborhood and reach out to others in Jesus' name. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are in need of healing in mind or body, especially Josephine Kamira, Phil May, Bob Maroney, Angelo Molina, Mario Yu, Irenea Rincon, Michael Exton, Mark Dalcon, Gregorio Valdez, Father Larry McNally, Joseph Costanzo, Antonio Beltran, Pamela Sweekins, Jim and Donna Baker, Mena McKinley, Rose Marie Schwartz, Frank and John Rovinsky, Father Ted Wojcik, J. Joanna Wright, Shirley Madison, Jose Herrera, Carla Janet Hernandez, Catherine Harvey, Javier Cesar Avalos, Mary Beth Hamilton, Joanne Paquette, Parita Tapas, Victorino Gallegos, Sister Mary Rust, Nora L. Ramirez, Karen Rigotti, Jim Costin, Leticia Rivera, Rosaura and Renee Delgado, Montserrat Trujillo, Aura Lizo, Jose Barasa, Kathleen McCarthy, Ernesto Navarro, and Miss Cassidy's father, and all who suffer from the coronavirus. May they feel the loving hand of God in the care they receive. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer,
for all who have died, especially Gregoria Pacheco, Eileen Quinlan, Tom Borowitz, Hugh Espacio, Timothy Chen, Damian Marin Martinez, Victor Hernandez Luna, and the Parish Remembrance Society, and all those who have died because of the pandemic. May God say to them, come, share your master's joy as my good and faithful servant. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pause now to remember the intentions of Sister Elisa M. Lopez and Berta Nikoshenko and all of our other needs, which we hold in the depths of our hearts. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Also pray for the reposal soul of Leonard Benashek. We pray to the Lord. All loving and giving and forgiving God, we ask that you hear all our prayers, the ones we have shared today, those deep within our hearts, through your beloved Son, Jesus, our light and hope, who lives with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Let us pray, my dear friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you, and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heads.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
God our Father, you have brought us here together so that we can give you thanks and praise for all the wonderful things you have done. We thank you for all that is beautiful in the world and for the happiness you have given us. We praise you for the daylight and for your word, Jesus Christ, which lights up our minds. We praise you for the earth and all the people who live on it, and for our life which comes from you. We know that you are good, you love us, and do great things for us, and so therefore we pray. Jesus was having supper with his apostles. He took bread from the table. He gave you thanks and prayers. Then he broke the bread and gave it to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the cup that was filled with wine. He thanked you and gave it to his friends and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." Then he said to them, "Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Father, because you love us, you invite us to come to your table. Fill us with the joy of the Holy Spirit as we receive the body and blood of your Son. Lord, you never forget any of your children. Remember especially our children of Queen of Angels, St. Matthias, Parish. Remember everyone today who is suffering from pain or sorrow. Remember Christians everywhere and all other people in the world. We are filled with wonder and praise when we see what you do for us through Jesus, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit,
All glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so now we have the courage to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer that peace to one another. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Please join in saying the prayer for spiritual communion, for when we cannot receive the Eucharist. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
First, I would like to thank our ministers who made this mass stream possible today. Thank you so much. I thank you for our ministers, Coda and Ethan, Kathy and Ambrose, and Kent, who works with the video. Thank you all very much, and God bless you. Also, I ask that you continue to pray for the unification of Queen of Anne St. Matthias Parish, that we do become a parish of living stones, revealing Jesus. To light to the world. Also, I want to thank all of you for your donations to the church, through Gift Central and through mail. They are much appreciated in helping us build the kingdom here, helping us serve all people without exception according to their needs. Thank you so much. Let us pray.
Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life, through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share of his life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May our Father's face always shine upon us. May the Son's love ever be in our hearts. May the Holy Spirit grant us health, happiness, and peace of mind. May we have a long life, good health, deep faith, and continue to keep safe. May Almighty God bless us all in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let's go in peace, through love, and serve the Lord. Have a wonderful day.
Oh, Lord.